Today's video is going to be about family, about me going home. I decided to go home during Mother's Day, but I didn't go home alone. I went home with me and my son, my youngest son. Me and LJ road trip to Louisiana during Mother's Day. I went home to check on my family, but most important, I went home to check on my mother-in-law. She was in a hospital, and I needed to check on her. As you guys know, I am a widow, and I believe family is very important. My husband believed family was very important. He believed that, and he stressed that so much in us. He implanted that in us so much, and I know that he would want me to check on his mom. So I knew I had to go home because his mom was very important to him, and that is my children's grandmother, and she's important to me. So though we were tired that Saturday, we knew we had to go no matter what. So we went a one-day road trip. It didn't matter what was going on. We knew we had to check on my mother-in-law, which granny, which what we called her. So while we was there, we went see a lot of people, a lot of family members, and we did a little shopping. We went put flowers on my parents' grave, my sister's grave. Those of you may not know that during the time I was dealing with my sister, because I lost my sister in 2015, and my husband was helping me go through the death of my sister, and who would have known 9 months later I would have lost my husband. So I was a lot to deal with in 2015. So family is very, very, very important to me. And so I knew I had to go and visit as many people as I possibly could with the little 24 hours that I did have. And I think I accomplished that. And of course, when you visit people in Louisiana, the first thing they want you to do, besides all the hugs and loving and all the good stuff they want you to do, the main important thing they would love for you to do, you must eat. Because with family, food is very, very important. You must eat and you must eat and you must eat. So you guys, sit back and enjoy me and my son. Yes, I didn't go along. Me and LJ road trip to Louisiana. Sit back and enjoy my family road trip to Louisiana. I hope you guys enjoy. Thanks again for watching. See you guys. Okay, we're in Madison, Texas. Of course, you can't stop through Madison without going to the traffic police. What is not like some comic book, right? Homemade potato chips, four pork sandwiches. Is this a Walmart or what? Let me just look. Put my boots on. If you're ever at a Buc-ee's, life hard. Pretty hard.
No, there's some over here. They're like less.
It's time for a glass of wine.
Okay,
where's
the rest of the family?
101 things to do with bacon. Really? Yes, I do. loved one. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. It's serious. Beach, please. Wait, look at this. It goes on and on and on and on and on and on.
Just saw my mother-in-law. So we just leave the hospital right now. And she's doing pretty good. I know it's kind of late. But we came in, we got to see her. So we're leaving the hospital right now. And about to go, just the elevator right here. About to go and get some boudin. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You see, maybe that's why I only lost 5 pounds. From boot camp, but I did lose 5 pounds, okay? So the boot camp do work. And you see this bad little rascal here?
That's what the real camp do in the street.
I lost 5 pounds, so the camp does work. And if I would have stuck to everything like I should have, probably lost more. But I mean, being from Louisiana, you know, we like to eat. So
I
we.
Don't.
We like to eat too. But he the one hollering for some boudin. Okay, so we on our way to some boudin. Some boudin. Yes, we can. The gas station. See, look at that. That's when you know you're in Louisiana. When you're at the hospital and you see a hospital alligator. Check it out. Ed Gator is the name. Okay, I am in the hood. Looking for some boudin. Little pot here. Put a boudin pot. At least with a pecan can is hot up. I got the pecan can in there, Elvin. Yeah, I tried. Okay, the best place to get the corn candy. Hi, y'all have some boudin? Okay, well, give me some of this corn candy. LJ, get your stuff.
Right.
You want this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well. Let me get to see this corn candy right here. Oh, this one. Oh, no, I don't want that one. Give me this corn candy right here. Look at this corn candy. This one, how much the, oh, that one, bro. How much the broken ones?
$1.99.
How much are these?
$2.99.
So the broken ones, $1.99? Okay, I'll get the broken ones for, let me have the broken ones for $1.99. I'm gonna get them too. Give me the broken ones for $1.99. Hold on, make sure you're bringing me up. How many I have? One, two, three, four. And that one. Thank you. All right. Okay, we're going to walk right here next door to see if they have the boudin. Of course, it was out of boudin. Everybody out of boudin this time of night. But I'm like this. Okay, it's Saturday night. People are going to clubs. And when they leave the club, what you going to think they're going to do after? They want some hot and spicy boudin. Well, I can't find no boudin. Now, we're going to try here. Let's go here. They got liquor. Because remember, we don't have no cutoff time to buy any liquor. You can buy liquor all time of day, any time of day. Any time of day. Let's see. Yeah, the pecan candy. Y'all see a boudin?
Frozen.
Oh, Lord. Okay. I don't want no frozen boudin. I want frozen boudin. I don't see frozen boudin anyway. Damn, this is a whole stove. Ah, it was remodeling.
They come from Quinn.
Oh, my eyes hurt. I just reserved it.
How long ago?
Like 5 minutes. You need my reservation? What thing?
It came through. It normally takes 15 minutes from the time you reserve it before it gets here to us, but we got it. I'm going to need your ID and credit card.
Towels and everything in the room?
Yes, ma'am.
And it's this breakfast like thing. What is that like?
It's you have your typical continental breakfast, and then we'll put out pre-cooked sausage patties and eggs.
Okay.
We don't cook it here on site. We just kind of warm them up. We'll have them in a warmer over there.
Okay. You wouldn't have any waffles?
Yep.
You do waffles?
We'll have waffles.
Oh, I like that. Then I'll take
we'll
that.
Have fruit, pastries, muffins, toast, cake, cereal. Oatmeal grits. Instant oatmeal.
Okay, well, that'll work for me. Do I need to sign? I'm going to say that.
For me. The bottom one is yours.
Okay. Oh, the bottom. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Just read over and initial each one of these and sign right there at the bottom. Do you have any pets?
No, ma'am. My son want me to get a dog or something, but I refuse to because I don't want any. Because somebody has
it's
to
like
look.
Taking care of a kid always.
God, I hope this room is pretty good. Okay. How you do this? Okay. All right, this is not bad. You got my spray? All right, this is me and LJ room. Oh, LJ, look, we got a refrigerator. So I don't think this is not bad for $86. What you think, LJ?
You could do ours,
man. I mean, besides the curtain hanging right here, but it's nice and cool in here. We have a refrigerator. We have our full-size mirror.
We got a full-size.
Huh? You don't lock?
It does have a ground lock.
We have a big screen like TV. Look, we have a microwave. And, okay. I think it's pretty nice. Main thing is having that in the bathroom. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Wait, bathroom. Okay. I like to have my comforter changed before.
My bed.
Which one is yours? Okay, LJ already picked his bed.
Yeah, mama, don't. It's whatever one you want, mama.
Well, I'll take this one. You already said you wanted that bed over there.
You
want to. Oh. I'll take this one. As long as you leave the air on.
This
one,
y'all
want to
hear
this
one?
Yeah. Okay. It's the next morning. And I have some breakfast.
Tell them how you slept.
You don't want to know.
Tell them about the friend you killed. Should have brought him. Should have brought him.
Okay, the hotel was it. It pays. Get your hotel early. That's what my son said. We should have got a hotel early. Okay, we had to move from our hotel room and go to another room. All hotels are booked because everybody want to come out here to play casino, I guess. So, of course, we're in North Lake Charles. They had us in the back part of the
North
hotel.
Lake Charles?
Yeah, in North Lake Charles.
Gosport.
Okay, that is
North. I don't know, but they ain't the North.
Okay.
Nothing always mean good, y'all.
Okay, yeah. Okay, we in the hood. My people, you know. We had to move twice. The hotel. And back. The second room. I ain't gonna tell you about the first bedroom. The bed. Okay, imagine. The sheets was not clean. So they moved to the second room, right? The damn spider. I had to put a spider in the bed. Literally. Had no more rooms. This is at Richmond Suites, okay? Richmond Suites. If you ever in Lake Charles, do not come to Richmond Suites. Richmond Suites should be a nice hotel, okay? I would have a, what happened to this place? Do not come to Richmond Suites. If you ever at the hotel, do not come here, okay? I don't know what really happened to Richmond Suites. It is. Okay, don't come here. I feel a damn spider. I sit on top of the sheets. LJ said he was scared to move. He stayed in one spot. So let me finish eating this continental breakfast here. I gotta go. Okay, this is where we stayed. The hotel, as you can tell, is real, real nice. I mean, can you see that? The hotel is nice. And it's a real big hotel.
but the part we stayed in really is the ghetto part, way in the back. But if we would have stayed in the front part, we would have had the luxury of the nice hotel. But since we came so late, we had to get the rough part. So, again, this is Richmond Suites. And it, I mean, it is a gorgeous hotel. I mean, it's big. But we got the rough end of the hotel. So, that's what happens when you get a hotel room late.
Okay, we're now leaving the hotel. We're on our way to Walmart in North Lake Charles. North Lake Charles is supposed to be a rough inner town. There's a lot of places where people like me live. North Lake Charles is supposed to be a poor inner town. But it has come a long way. But anyway, we're on our way to Walmart in North Lake Charles to pick up a few things such as sausage. Things that I'm going to take back to Dallas. Sausage. Any souvenirs that I want to take back, seasoning, and then after we leave Walmart, we're going to go to the graveyard so I could put some flowers on my mom's grave, my father's grave, my sister's grave. Then after that, we're going to go to the hospital again so we can see my mother-in-law to see how she's doing and wishing her a happy Mother's Day. Also, we need to get a Mother's Day card for my mother-in-law. Then we're going to go by my in-law's house and see some of them. Then we're going to go by my sister's house and see my family. Then after we pick up some crawfish or some fried fish, then hopefully we'll hit the interstate to come back to Dallas. And look at that sign, says ball crawfish. Wow, that's a beautiful sign. Let me, in Lake Charles, I tell you one thing. The people are friendly. Here is a small community with population about 75,000-78,000 people where no one is really a stranger. People sit on a porch and they wave at people. And it's okay. They're not trying to rob you. They're just friendly people. We like to eat. We like to cook. We like to dance and try to Caucasian music, where everyone is friendly and it's okay for you to speak back. Sit back, please, and enjoy the rest of my video and our trip to Lake Charles.
Okay, show them the card you got.
Some say Nana, some say Granny, Grams, Grammy. No matter how you say it, it all means love. Happy Mother's Day.
See? You said that's simple. You see that, right? All righty. Check it out. Look, you know I'm a Saints fan. 547, hell no. Hell yeah, I'm gonna get me something. Oh, it's for our Christmas tree. Can you have a lower on the prices?
They're like $2
I know. Yeah, you know I'm in Louisiana. When you see we're in Walmart. Here they go right here. Gotta take my glasses off of this one. See, look. Here you go.
Come on, man.
See these right here?
We're at Walmart. Yeah, dude. We got some ants on, man. While we
look. There's 138
of
me.
Look at you. That's it right there.
You see them?
Yeah, right.
Anyway, here they go right here. These are the green onions. I told you about these green onions. These sauce chill are slam. Nothing in that purse. Might need to get another cooler. My son is also here helping me.
He's doing all the work.
No, he's not, but he's here. All right, thanks. Bye.
Okay, it's getting hot. I realize it. Okay, we're here at the graveyard, and I'm going to stop filming. But we're here to put flowers on my mother and father's grave today. Again, it's Mother's Day. So that's where we are at right now. So, again, if you do have a mother, a father, or you have a mother right now, you are blessed. So, I am going to do this, so I have to talk to you guys later. I won't be filming no more at the grave. Thank you. Bye.
Oh, Lord, geez,
that's my parents. I think the flowers came out beautiful. Great. These deep graves. I mean, these deep ditches. You see these ditches right here? If you get stuck in these ditches, you're out of luck. I just want to show you that. They're on both sides. You see them ditches there? These are some deep ditches. Ditches. Yeah. Okay, we just leave it in the hospital again. So I'm saying, my mother-in-law, she was dressed, sitting up. She was doing pretty good. I said, but see one of my brother-in-law and my sister-in-law. So it's, of course, me and LJ. We left the grave. It has to be about 100 degrees. We feel like it's 100 degrees out here. What's that call? Oh, yeah. Okay, how old you are? Might as well. Is that pork done?
No,
it's Stacy. Oh my God, look at that.
But I'm about to make the potato salad because they don't eat
potato salad,
Tom.
I have to eat potato. Look at God. look what God did. I do eat potato salad. Look at God. See how when you come to your brother-in-law house, what is the condensed milk for?
We got a pina colada kicking.
You already know. Where's the other one? The beans are good. Where the fried ribs at? Rice. Okay, look at the fried ribs. What's in this one? Mac and cheese. These are fried ribs. I'm gonna take me a piece of the fried rib. Where's the napkin at?
Naya, where your brother? Naya!
Hi, mate.
I know, but
bye, Aunt.
All right, bye-bye, y'all. Be careful.
Love you.
Bye, be careful, all right.
Bye, baby. Love you. Nice
bye.
To meet you, baby.
Bye, my baby.
I love you.
Bye.
Love you.
Bye.
Bye,
sweetie. Bye, baby. Take care.
I love you.
Take care.
All right. Yeah, be careful.
All right.
All right.
Love you. Come here, my baby. Check out the Louisiana women. Yep. Look at my two nieces, okay. This is Louisiana girls. They
Come on, on YouTube page.
Yes.
Come on.
That's right.
Come on.
You know what? It's time for me to go home.
Get a yay.
You want to see Michelle?
I done had fried ribs. Rice dressing. Pork beans, potato salad. I'm on my way. We're in Bassett, Texas, whatever the world it is. But I am on my way to, I see a little place over here, so I'm going to buy me a fruit stand. So I'm going to get me a watermelon. So I'm going to turn it around. See this right here? This stand here. And see what they have so you guys can see it too, okay? All right. How fresh these are. Oh, you gonna close up? Oh, they are so big. Oh, check this one out. See this? Is these tomatoes fresh? From a garden?
No, that is South Texas.
South Texas? It's from a garden? Oh, they look good.
I mean, how can you tell though?
Good hollow sound.
A hollow sound?
Yes, ma'am.
How you pluck them? That sound hollow.
Yeah, that one.
And this one here, LJ, I want this one. This was hollow to me. Okay, $9.95?
Yes, ma'am.
Who grow them, you?
No, they're out of South Texas.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
You too. Uh-oh. I'm stuck in here. Thank you. Have a great day.
Hey, everyone. This is Cajun Trail coming to you live in Dallas, Texas. I want you to know I had a fantastic time in my city of Lake Charles, Louisiana. Of course, I didn't go along with me and my son, and you know the drama that sometimes he can cause. Okay, but it was all about mothers. And for those who want that, who do have a mother, you should treasure your mother because your mother is only here for a short period of time. So again, I went down to see my mother-in-law, and for those who do not know, I am a widow. And for my new subscribers, I thank you for subscribing. For my old subscribers, what's up? So, again, this channel is dedicated really to my husband. So what I do, I have been cooking everything my husband taught me how to cook. For those who do not know, I did not know how to cook anything. So my husband taught me everything about cooking and how important cooking is. But anyway, I had a fantastic time, but I am back home in the city of Dallas. So again, I had a fantastic time, and I hope you are enjoying my channel.